I'm Abby Bangzer. I'm a principal engineer at an organization called Syntasso, where we're building the free and open source framework Cradix for helping organizations build their own custom internal platforms. I think what we're seeing today is the customization in an organization around platforms. So PaaS, or platform as a service, had its moment 10, 15 years ago, and it showed us what is possible while still leaving something to be desired because it was not custom to our organizations. We were feeling this pressure of either use this product off the shelf or build completely from scratch. And what I think we're seeing today is this need to leverage managed services, get the benefits that we saw platforms as a service provide, these managed services provide fast delivery to production while still keeping in mind what makes your organization special. There's a platforms working group, which was underneath the technical advisory group for app delivery. So this is within the CNCF. There are technical advisory groups. The app delivery one focuses on how you get your business value applications to production using cloud native technologies. Often you think just about the software. There's developer experience has been shorthanded to application developer experience. But what we realize when talking about delivering applications is it's not just a piece of software in a container. It's also the infrastructure that goes with it. It's the queuing, it's the databases, it's all the messaging services. It's all these things that your application depends on to be scaled and successful. Well, how does that get packaged? How does that get to production safely and in a coordinated way? And what we found is that platforms is really the leveraging mechanism there and how to be successful. Yeah, I think open source is about being able to leverage what's around you. And with open source, you're leveraging the world of technology and all the engineers and organizations around the world that are doing the same things as you are. And I think we're seeing that with, for example, Kubernetes. When you build your platform on top of the Kubernetes API, you get for free access to so many powerful tools and aspects. You need to think about things like role-based access control. There are tools for that. You need to think about things like compliance or pipelines. There are tools for that built for the Kubernetes API that are easily interoperable. And that's the power of open source, is that sort of interoperability and leveraging of shared problem spaces. Recently, the Platforms Working Group has released a white paper titled The Platform Engineering Maturity Model. And this model lays out five key aspects that we have found important to defining the maturity of an organization's investment in their internal platforms. Then four levels at which that organization may want to invest. And one of the things I'm most proud of with this model is that it doesn't tell people that they're not good enough or that they have to be at level four to be able to say that they're building a platform. It actually focuses on what is the business value to your organization. If you're a small organization, you may not need to get to the scaled level on this model. If you are thousands of developers, you may realize why you're struggling because your platform is only operating at a more provisional level when you need that scale supported. So I think that this model, which is boiled down to a single table, is backed by 15 pages of detailed examples and ways for organizations to see themselves in these aspects. And I think that's going to be a really great way for people to have concrete next steps when it comes to platform engineering. The thing I'm most focused on these days is focusing on the thinnest viable platform, which has been described by the Team Topologies group, or otherwise described as a floating platform by Gregor Hope. In both cases, what they talk about is that your business has unique aspects that need to be specialized to your organization. But so much of your organization is non-differentiating. How you do container stores, non-differentiating possibly. How you do networking, non-differentiating. And so how do we enable organizations to customize the top layer of their platform and continue to absorb from the industry all of the commodities that become available to us? Great example is, you know, zero downtime deployment of databases. Tough problem. That was a custom solution just a couple years ago. Today, the cloud providers are starting to provide that for their managed database services. If you have a custom zero downtime harness for your organization, don't keep managing it if you don't have to. Switch to the managed service so that you can leverage what's coming out of cloud providers. That's keeping your platform thin and focused on your business value rather than getting tied to that lower level technology. And I think that's most important.